Howdy everybody, ArgonMatrix here. Welcome to episode 67 of The Binding of Isaac Afterbirth Plus. I think today I kind of scoped out things beforehand. I want to try a Lilith run to the chest here. Just cause, you know, I'm just kind of throwing random characters at a wall to see what'll stick right now. XL3B TCVE. And I do enjoy playing as Lilith. It's been a little while, I feel like. Curse of the Labyrinth on the first floor is always an interesting time. Thankfully, Lilith does start with some spirit hearts here, so it's not going to be that bad to try and protect our deal with the devil chances. We also get to two item rooms without having to spend any keys, so that's pretty sweet as well. We'll take a crack at it here. What else does Lilith have to do? She has Boss Rush and Hush already done, not Delirium, so that'll be something we have to strive for at some point here. But again, Delirium is one of those things that I don't necessarily like attempt to do. Like, I don't go out of my way to be like, alright, this is going to be a Delirium run. Unless that's like actually just the last thing that I have to do as that character, then I might start focusing more on that. But for me right now, it's mostly like try to get the main unlocks, like the cathedral and the chest and all that stuff, the dark room. And then after that's all done, or like possibly when that's even when that's happening, like if I get a dark room run and it's really powerful, and then I get a void portal at the end of that, I might be like, sure, let's try a Delirium fight, cause why not? That kind of seems like what it's intended for anyway. Just like a final super boss fight, like one last little challenge, in case you're interested. Crack the Sky is not really too interesting to me right now, cause obviously part of Lilith's flavor is the Box of Friends being such a good item, especially. So we'll keep that for now. Crack the Sky is actually not that bad. I kind of have like a tainted perception of it from Vanilla Isaac, where it was actually like just like one of the worst spacebar items because it didn't have any sort of like homing or aim to it. It was literally just like random chance whether any of the beams of light would hit the enemies. I'm pretty sure it was random chance anyway. It might have gone up based on luck or something, but I don't know. Judging by the state of affairs of some other items in the Vanilla Isaac, I don't know if Crack the Sky had that much intricacy put into it. It's entirely possible, I suppose. That was rough. Rooms like that can be pretty rough with Lilith. Thankfully, we got kind of paid out there, so we got bailed out, which I should say. It's been a while. I guess you kind of have to, if you want to stay good with Lilith, you kind of have to do a Lilith run every so often, because like if you don't play Lilith for a while, you're gonna get so accustomed to every other character who doesn't have their hitbox like offset from where they're firing like this, and you're just gonna be totally confused. But I think we'll be okay here. I was about to say I'm on a roll, but you know that doesn't really apply just yet. I'm still on the Curse of the Labyrinth first floor basement area, and we don't really have much to our name at this point, so I can't really tell. It's one of those situations where you just can't really predict where the run is going to go just yet. We've had one item, and it's been Crack the Sky, which wasn't even takeable, so it's alright. Hopefully our other item is a little better than that. The Stonies are actually one of the worst enemies you can come up against with Lilith, by the way, because they block your shots so easily compared to other characters. Thankfully, these guys kind of all the other enemies in the room just kind of detonated themselves, so I didn't have to worry about it as much. Still kind of annoying. I don't really want that. Anti-grav tears? That could get weird. I don't know how well it's going to work with Lilith, but we'll try it, I guess. It does give me a tears upgrade at the very least. Broken remote is not interesting at all to me. There are potential uses for broken remote, I'll be the first to admit that. But I don't think they're all that strong. I probably should have placed that bomb a little better to try and get the stone chest at the same time, but no harm, no foul. Alright, we got the Duke of Flies, should be easy enough. Takes a couple rooms to kind of get used to firing with anti-grav tears, I'll admit that. I don't know, for enemies like this, where the pattern is so set, it might be best to just kind of set traps like this and wait for him to just kind of maneuver into them on his own. Seems to be working out fairly well. Alright, old bandage is fine by me, more deal with the devil fodder. I'll head back, grab this battery up here, and keep on moving. off their first deal with the devil is something quite nice. I feel like I've handicapped myself just a little bit with anti-grav tears. See, the thing about anti-grav tears is that, like, early on it's pretty okay, just because, just almost solely for the fact that it is a tears upgrade, a pretty significant tears upgrade most of the time. But there's almost no case where having anti-grav is better than not having anti-grav. Know what I mean? It's like, if you have really good tears, anti-grav is not going to penalize you that much, but having them without anti-grav would penalize you actually zero, so it's kind of weird that way. Matchbook is fine, gave us some more bombs to work with. We got Guppy's Hairball, and I don't know how much I like this. It's not the best deal with the devil I've ever seen, I'll tell you that much. I think I'm gonna... There's the chance for Guppy there, but I'm gonna forego it and see if we can make a deal with the angel run work. We gotta get that Mega Satan thing going with everybody, so... Might as well try it here. Could this be the run? I don't know. I'm feeling good about it. I'm feeling spunky. Gonna check out that, I'll check out the mob trap room shortly once I get a box of friends charge. I don't know, four enemies that do charge you down, I will say that anti-grav tears can be a little better in that case. But I still don't think that justifies them as an item necessarily. I mean, that's kind of a harsh way of putting it, I suppose. If that's not how I meant for that to come out, but I think you kind of know what I mean. I mean, the onus really falls to me, doesn't it? I'm the one who took the stupid item and knowing full well what it would do. I actually wasn't fully sure that it would work with Lilith, but here we are learning things today that may benefit us in the future. Okay, that was kind of sucky. It's rare that these faceless silkworms can actually put you in a bit of a bind. But so they proved their will. Alright, let's check out the mob trap room now. Could be totally worthless, or could be great. I'll try this out. I feel like I only have three keys, so I won't be able to open every chest, but I feel like the odds of one of these chests paying out with a key is probably high enough for me to justify this. Or I could just get some really good items out of these. I could get Goat Head, I could get Guppy's Head, I could get all sorts of different heads. That's fine. Cricket's Head even would probably be the one I'm most interested in. I don't know, Goat Head might be plausible as well. It's easier to make deals with the angel work that way. Alright, easy enough. Now we can actually go ahead and do this. Yeah, that's more than one key, I would say. We're gonna pretty much break even here, almost. Black Tooth, I forget what it does. I think it's the occasional... chance. It's like an occasional chance at a... Tough Love shot, one of the Tooth shots, I think. Maybe. That might be the case. I guess we'll see when push comes to shove here. If we end up seeing any teeth, we'll know where it's coming from. This is a kind of a nasty room. Oh yeah, I did see a tooth shot there. It seems like a weird, like, dead tooth shot, though. I mean, I guess that makes sense with it being a black tooth. It was like a tooth shot that also poisoned the enemy, so it's kind of interesting. I'll put it in that cloud of trinkets that's, takeable, but easily replaceable. I don't know, it's kind of like a weird pinky eye, almost. It might actually just be like an objectively better pinky eye, except I don't know how the luck scaling works compared to pinky eye. Because I know pinky eye, you get probably a lot more shots than I'm getting out of this one. Oh god. This is just the exact same room, practically, come on. Except there's champions in here. Champions of fire, even. This is getting a little hectic. Kind of wishing I had a box of fringe charge right now, but we'll manage one way or another. What's this portal doing? It's just like, it's not even spawning anything. It's kind of scaring me. Okay, this is... this is just a little too much, man. I'm getting stressed out now. I don't know, maybe the portal was just out of potential to spawn, but somehow just didn't want to disappear. It's a weird situation. All I know is that I'm going to need to start picking up some damage upgrades at some point with Lilith here, or else I'm going to be in a long downward spiral, I think, towards my eventual oblivion. Like, honestly, game, if you're not going to give me any, oh, B, be careful what you wish for. I was going to say, if you're not going to give me any damage upgrades. Sure, I hate myself. Let's try it. Use mascara. Oh, this is probably the worst idea I've ever had, but... You know, I asked for the damage upgrade. The game gave it to me. Here we are now. Alright. Get ready for another hour-long slog, potentially. I don't know. These tears do a lot of damage now, so... That much is, I can be thankful for, at least. There goes my deal with the, Devil slash Angel chance. Probably, anyway, at any rate. Thankfully, old bandages kind of keep me alive. Honestly, though, game, if you're not gonna give me anything to really work with, because use mascara, it's like, okay, haha, funny joke, damage upgrade, right. But if you're not gonna give me anything reasonable to work with, just, like, kill me now. Let me start a new run. Don't waste my time, please. I'll do this run. You bet your ass I'll do this run, and I'll make it work. If you really want to make me sit through this, but... Alright, PhD is good enough. What do we got? An explosive diarrhea. This could be... I mean, let's just... Honestly, probably not going to have a better use for it than this. Getting rid of those mushrooms. We didn't even get anything out of it. I thought with maybe with PhD, we'd be able to benefit from that somewhat, but... No dice. Alright, always go for these black poops in the middle. I don't know if you always want to go for them first, necessarily, but... It does render all these guys basically on 1 HP, I found. Even the champion ones take far fewer hits. Got lucky there that most of them didn't even end up spawning any silkworms, that's cool. Probably worth it to look for a secret room here. I need to kind of press every advantage I can right now. Also, if I could go back and get a charge ready for the boss fight, that would be swell, too. I don't know, there might just be a battery charge land on the ground somewhere, in which case fighting this room is a little bit moot, but... Well, let's get some practice in against these guys anyway. These are going to be some of the worst enemies to come up against, so... I think... I don't know, maybe the best idea is to try and tap shoot with this? Against these guys anyway? Oh, come on. Oh, that tooth shot would have been so good. Oh, get him. There we go. All right, that's good. All right, what do we got for our card? The stars. I will save that for the next floor and hopefully not get fucked over by it. What do we got here? We got money. All right. I will make that work. Give myself a little bit of better deal chance. 23% is still not great, especially given the fact that I'm probably going to get hit on the boss and reduce that to like a 0.5% chance, but... You know, I'll take anything I can get at the moment. I am a desperate Lilith right now. The stain is not the greatest in the world. Thankfully, I think this is a variant of the stain that does not, doesn't ever do any bullet hell attacks. It just like spawns enemies and creates this creep. Which, I mean, could be debatably worse for us than a bullet hell thing, but it feels alright for me. See, the good thing about Eve's Mascara right now is that it does work pretty well against bosses for the most part. Against regular enemies, it's kind of hit or miss, but against bosses, it does make them go quite a bit faster than it would otherwise. Okay, well, that was just a cheap shot. I'm not very happy about the... Come on, give me that. Gonna make the hearts run away from me on this run, too? Really? Alright, got Magic 8 Ball, which is a shot speed up, which works pretty well with Eve's Mascara. Death, I would like to take, but I'd rather keep the Stars card. Let's give it a whirl here. Still making okay time, given the state of affairs. Curse of the Blind's kind of a bitch. The Inner Eye, oh my god. Do you see this tier rate right now? Oh my lord. Alright. Well, anytime we do hit an enemy, it's gonna be the worst day of their lives. But we can only hit one enemy roughly every 10 minutes, so... Jesus Christ. It's gonna take a while, but we'll make it work. I'd rather not, like, have to make it work. I'd rather the run work for me, in a way. Like, the best thing I could probably find right now is maybe with PhD, there could be, like, a tears up pill in the rotation. And if I could get that going and then maybe find a placebo or something, we could be in business here. As it stands, though, not so much. I'd like one of these guys to just, like, pop up into one of these swirls of tears that I'm leaving about. These little minefields. I feel like a boss in Diddy Kong Racing or something. Just, like, occasionally just pooting out little obstacles behind me for the enemy to run into. Like a stupid octopus. Oh, God. Oh, where'd they go? I can't even really use bombs if I wanted to be offensive here, because I only have four. So I gotta save those for when the time is right here. I'm not gonna go to that big room just yet, because I think it could behoove me to have Box of Friends ready for that room. Of course, Box of Friends on this room would actually probably have been a good investment as well, but I couldn't have really known, could I? We'll make it work regardless. That's gonna be a catchphrase of this fucking video. We'll make it work. It's alright. It's not like I'm having a bad time or anything, it's just I really am hurting for some tears upgrades at this point. Is it my own fault for taking Eve's mascara? Inner eye? I mean, inner eye is debatable. You could say, oh, you shouldn't take Curse of the Blind items, like, ever, because it could always be something nasty like that screws you up. Yeah, but by the same token, it could be something, like, great that you're just missing out on by not taking it. So you just really never know in that regard. And I think it's probably worth it most of the time, because most of the time, Curse of the Blind will not fuck you over. It won't always necessarily benefit you greatly, but it's not going to be the end of your run most of the time either. If you're on, like, a super high streak, like, if you got, like, a 100 streak going or something, I might think twice about it, just because I'd hate for a streak like that to end off of the back of something nasty like that. But Eve's mascara, I will totally accept the blame for, honestly. But I don't know. It's debatable whether this is actually whether Eve's mascara was the right pick, whether the tears downgrade will justify the damage upgrade. At this moment, it's not feeling so great to me. Gonna be honest with you there. Big Horn, huh? At least he's not as tanky as he used to be. I was hoping to get a pill out of that. Something nice, you know, like maybe a Balls of Steel to make me feel a little more comfortable about my odds. That's okay, though. I mean, hey, at least with Box of Friends active, this is much, much better. Because it effectively, what Box of Friends does for me is effectively doubles my tier rate, so it makes up for basically the one Achilles heel right now this run. Well, I shouldn't say the one Achilles heel. We are sitting on 3 HP as well, one of which is incorporeal. So, but it looks like we will get a deal here. Deal with the angel or devil, potentially. Deal with the angel, okay. Placenta is fine by me. What we got in here? We got Sacred Heart, huh? That's a big tears downgrade and a big, oh my god, big damage upgrade. It's a really, really good item, and it does give us homing tears. Our tears are great, but I'm holding down the button right now, and look how often I'm firing. This is not good, man. I guess, hell, we'll test it out against the angel here. If you're going through hell, keep going. I mean, homing tears makes this a little more bearable. I will readily admit that. And look at the fucking damage we do. I mean, I think Sacred Heart, even if I had known it was Sacred Heart and the tears downgrade I would have gotten from it, I still would have picked it up in a heartbeat. Ha! Heartbeat. Get it? Sacred Heart? Never mind. Is that going to get both of them? Get one of them? I'm willing to do this. I'm willing to spend one bomb on each of these fires for the hopes of a Spirit Heart. Obviously did not work out so well for me. That's okay. Should I head out and look for a shop? That might be worthwhile, honestly, just to buy some HP, if nothing else. Or if I could just, like, find HP, that would also be good. So, this is not a room I want to be a part of right now. I need to get this. Oh my god, I almost just, like, died right there by being fucked in a corner. Thank you, old Bandage, for being the savior this run does not deserve right now. I've never thought I would curse myself by asking for so much, but by asking for damage. The game is just not being nice about it right now. Health up, sure. Why not? Oh, greed. All right. Well, at least we can take him out in like three little volleys here. It's not so bad. And he did drop a steam sail for us. That should be a steam sail anyway. I don't know what else it could be. Placenta will be really nice for us as well here. It will be nice for us as well here. We got one key piece on our side too, so Mega Satan is on the playing field. Do I feel entirely confident about going up against Mega Satan? I mean, obviously not right now, but ideally we'll have more upgrades between now and Mega Satan that will make Mega Satan a little bit easier. I mean, you would think, given the amount of floors we still have to go through, that we have a pretty decent shot of making something work for us. See, this is the problem. Like, my tears do so much damage, but they fire so infrequently that I have to dodge so much just waiting for them. Rooms like that are fine by me, though. Give me more one enemy rooms and I'll be a happy camper. We got more money, that's fine. That guy's gonna get eaten alive. Alright, go for the portal, I think. And then just hope this guy jumps right into my line of fire here, maybe? Yeah, there we go. Cursed Room is an interesting prospect. Not one that I'm super invested in at the moment. Oh, goddammit. That would have actually hit that guy, but I had to fire it. There we go. Check this out, just in case. Nope. Not interested. Not at all. There could be a secret room potentially next to that cursed room. That might make it a little more viable here. Check it out. I think it's worth checking out, honestly. I didn't know. Didn't know if it would be. The odds were not very high, I don't think. Ooh, okay. Well, that was dumb. This is also dumb. There we go. I really need to... It's become almost like a weird strategy game at this point. I need that heart. Fuck, that was scary. Like, I can't just hold down the fire button like you normally do in Isaac here. I have to very carefully and strategically place these little volleys of tears to make stuff work here. To make stuff work. Alright, item room. This could be huge potential for us. What would really help this run out? I don't know. Big tears upgrade. Cue the inevitable appearance of soy milk in that item room. No, so it's like a curse of the monkey's paw type situation right now. So I wouldn't be surprised really. Oh wow, that was close. There we go. The homing shots are really really nice for us. Data fucking miner, you would. Try it once. We got a damage upgrade. That was a significant damage upgrade, actually. You know what? I'm happy to have used it once, but data miner is no friend of mine. You know, just because you shared your cookies with me one time at lunch, that doesn't make us friends. You're still the asshole who wedged me in the bathroom. It's like, come on. You may think I have some latent experience with childhood bullies that just got vented out a little bit there. No, it's just more of a general statement, you know? Alright, restock is interesting. We do have steam sail as well. Restock and diplopia are both interesting. I think... I guess you take both, maybe. Take restock first, obviously. It's the clearer option. Bombs are key. Not sure about that. I guess I'll yeah, I'm gonna do it and I'll bomb this guy. Potentially higher deal chance. I mean, that's not the be-all end-all 11.5% right now. Don't wait. We'll keep Diplopia for now. Actually, no. Sorry, I'm going with doing this back and forth all the time, but keep Box of Friends for right now to maybe clear out some of the tougher rooms along the way. And then bring Diplopia into the boss fight on the off chance that you get a deal or that the item on the that the boss gives me itself is worth doubling. And obviously Diplopia on like a deal with the devil or even a deal with the angel potentially could be nice. Nice. Of course, the odds of that, as stated, are not extraordinarily high. But that's okay. Got a key out of our situation there. We're actually looking surprisingly good on the HP front, thanks to a lucky series of tinted rocks on this floor. Yeah, these guys walking right into the tears does help. Aw, goddammit. I forgot that the weird, like, puddle that he becomes also is affected by his armored face. How many people would understand that sentence in out of context? This is probably worth it. Rusted key. Gives me more chests, I think. Possibly just more keys, I don't know. All I'm saying is that Black Tooth, on a different run, I could see it being pretty good. On this run, I don't think it's really contributing that much. Alright, I should have, I forgot my own rule. I was going to go back for Diplopia. But we'll see whether that even matters here. Okay, it doesn't seem to have mattered. I will go back for it right now, though, just because I want to keep Box of Friends to the next floor, and I paid for Diplopia, so I might as well use it to get two speed upgrades instead of one. God damn it. I'll take the bombs anyway. Didn't want to use that key, but it is what it is. Have a cent. I could also Diplopia this room, which might be the better option. It would give me a free nightlight and then some consumables and a pill that's guaranteed to be at least not terrible. Or do I want the extra speed? I think this will be fine. Just having the one wooden spoon is more than enough. Explosive diarrhea is not the greatest pill in the world, but it's not bad. And let's get a move on with our bad selves. I will say, someone brought this up in a comment that I think this might be the first time that I've had nightlight since switching to a controller. But being able to use it with an analog stick is so much more useful than just the regular WASD type situation. Really, really makes a world of difference. I'm realizing that right now. I don't know how well I'm going to be able to control it here when I'm focusing on actually making sure these shots land as well. But we'll try. We will try. I was honestly kind of worried that the mom's hands there would go up before I got the chance to get another shot off. Thankfully, my tier rate's not quite that bad, but, you know. Alright, we got one more shot at a decent item room here. Hopefully it'll come along sooner rather than later and be the savior that this run really needs right now. I mean, it doesn't really need it. I'll make this run work, and it has gotten a lot better since the days of just Eve's Mascara, Anti-Grav, Triple Shot Hell. Sacred Heart on its own has kind of come through to save the run, and Data Miner, I will admit. I don't know if this was strictly necessary to use Box of Friends here, but I felt a little endangered, so. And I really want to protect the Spirit Hearts that I have right now. Because I don't have a guaranteed deal on this floor, so. I feel like I'm just preserving to the next floor and get a guaranteed deal. Question mark card is probably a lot better than Explosive Diarrhea for us. So we can get three charges of Box of Friends, or we just get an emergency charge of Box of Friends or something. Alright, do that. Hopefully get some Spirit Hearts. No such luck. I mean, not surprising, our luck stat is zero. Throw that in the pile of stats that are not so great right now. Admittedly, 22 damage, pretty insane. The rest, it's hit or miss. Alright, Cancer is really nice. Not sure exactly what my HP is up to right now, but I'm not gonna say no to Cancer, that's for sure, especially with the added wafer effect. That'll be immensely useful on later floors. Alright, what do we got in here? Super Greed, I expected no less, quite frankly. Just give me the quarter and be done with you. Oh, he actually did. How about that? Not really going to matter unless I come across some sort of a beggar situation, but it's not super unlikely, I guess. Yeah, it's worth it to check this out. I have a golden key, so the magician is worthless for me. Because I already have the homing shots. I cannot believe how slow this tier 8 is. I am actually holding down the button, believe it or not. It's just so mesmerizingly slow. Not worth that yet. Might be worth it to come back for that charge later on, but... Okay, well... There's not much else I can really do on this floor, unless I want to hunt down a secret room really quick. Potentially here. I might have misplaced that bomb, but even if I did. Alright, let's go ahead down here. Mom, you shouldn't be that bad. This is a box of friends usage that I've never quite considered, because I've never had quite this low of a tier rate with Lilith, I feel like. That's good, though. Okay, so you take the Polaroid, right? Yeah, we want to go to the chest to get as many unlocks as possible here. That's pretty swell. We're actually at full HP, so that's really nice. I don't have any fucking bombs because I used the one I had. God damn it. Well, it's okay. No bombs in here either. The bomb rocks. Can I just pick one up and bring it with me? That's fine. We'll hope for another deal with the angel on one of the later floors. And I'll preserve my bombs a little better this time. That was just dumb on my part. I really did not anticipate getting a deal with the angel there, even though our chance was pretty good, I suppose. We will have a not the greatest chance on this floor, but on the next floor we should have a nice chance. What was I saying, though? I don't even remember now. Oh god. Bit of a lag spike there, but that's okay. Oh, I was talking about the box of friends usage. Yeah, because on the mom fight there, my tier rate was so low that it really, the best idea for me was to not use box of friends right away, but was to first fire a charge, and then in between me firing my first and my second charge, then use the box of friends, so that the second incubus that gets spawned in gets the effect of, or gets to like fire right away. So it kind of makes it like a pseudo halving of my tier rate, or not halving, but doubling, or whatever. Whichever one's best, I suppose. I guess having might be the best. Have or have not, there is no try. That's not how the quote goes, I know, but... This is not my idea of a fun room, I'm gonna be honest with you. Oh, come on, man. Alright, just line it up, there we go. Just gonna line them up and knock them down. Give me that key. I will explore this room until I find a bomb, and if I don't find a bomb, well, that's just rude on your part, game. Quite honestly. Because you can see here, I did not do that strategy where I wait for the charge to use Box of Friends. I just used it, and now they're both on the same timer for the tiers. So the time between my firings is no different than if I only have one incubus. I guess it doesn't matter how close I get to that guy, he's not shooting at me, so... I really just need one bomb. That's all I need. I can survive just fine on the back of what I got right now, but that one bomb is going to make all the difference in case I encounter another angel statue on this floor. Or the next. Could very well be the next. I could also just get a devil deal. That would kind of upset me, because I do have the first key piece ready here. Don't be tempted by that tinted rock either. I mean, not that I can be tempted by it right now, because I don't have any bombs, but... If I do find a bomb, that is. There we go, okay. Actually... Is there a way to get to that bomb with the one bomb that I have? I guess there kind of is, but I don't know if there's a way to get the tinted rock in that explosion radius. I don't think there is, and I'm not willing to test it, because... Knowing my luck right now, this will be the only bomb that we get for this entire floor, so... So let's just preserve it, and protect it with our lives. Ideally, we'll get more bombs at some point in the future. We'll check out this library, potential bookworm status. I don't know what these books are, but they can't be that bad, right? Just want to clear these things out so that they don't get my goat here. Oh, come on, man. Alright, Satanic Bible is fine, and the Necronomicon is eh. At best, it's eh. And we gotta move on. See ya. It's just kind of fun to do that. Just, like, walk up to that guy. He can't shoot back, so it's like, alright, here you go. I should do this, I guess. Because that'll get me the bomb and the key, so no sense in not doing it. I'll try it. Don't know if that was at all worth it. I was hoping for a bomb into that situation, but, you know, more keys. We are going down to the chest today, so hopefully that'll help us at some point here. Oh, God. That was an invisible man. Oh, he is an invisible man. He's an invisible champion. That's the problem. Alright, where is he? He's doing very well at camouflaging himself. There we go. Alright, second bomb. I will go back for that tinted rock now. It could be... Oh god, that was just dumb. I will not even try to defend that. Could be like small rock or something, maybe? I don't know. Golden chest with keys and stuff. Alright, that's fine. That is fine. Okay, again, though? let's not hemorrhage this HP. We've been given a second chance on this run after taking... After taking fucking Eve's mascara here. Let's not waste it. This opportunity comes once in a lifetime, yo. So, do not miss your chance to blow. That's my own unique creative lyric that you just heard right there. So, you don't copy it. Don't repeat it anywhere else. If you hear it anywhere else, it's me. It's mine. Alright, I got a damage and range up, which is not a tiers upgrade. So, that's all I need to know about that. And we will not get any sort of item from Mom's Heart, so the chances of a tiers upgrade at this point in the game are very slim. So this may just be what we have to rock out with for most of the rest of the game here, unless we get something nice on the chest. Okay, I'm in a bit of a scary position right now. My HP is still okay. I'm excited is not a good pill. I don't know how PhD got that one confused. But in my ability to get a deal with the angel or devil on this floor, I'm feeling a little compromised right now. I will check this in case there's a bomb inside. There are three bombs inside, which lets me get this tinted rock. Nice, nice, nice. I need that spirit heart right now for the protection. Getting a deal with the angel on this room, or on this floor rather, is paramount. It's not paramount to my success. But I would like to try and to do a Mega Satan run because the potential is there. Okay, I will actually just blow these guys up. I could have played them with the cancer effect especially, but the heightened deal with the angel chance is too good to pass up. I think. Do I want either of these? I mean, umbilical cord is worth nothing ever. Rarely do I ask for like a straight up buff in Isaac. Because, like, obviously some items are meant to be good, some items are meant to be bad. That's how the game is balanced. And trinkets are affected the same way. But umbilical cord? I have never once run into a situation where I'm like, I want the umbilical cord. Never. And I can't fathom a situation where it would be useful either. For those not privy, what umbilical cord does, I think I've been over this in previous... So what does this do for me? I mean, I know what it does, but does it give me like a tiers up downgrade? I guess we'll see. Alright, it doesn't really affect my stats at all, so just the chance to spawn money, which is whatever. It also makes my tiers fucking golden and sweet as hell, so I think that on its own might be worth it. But yeah, umbilical cord, for the uninitiated out there, when you fall to half of a red heart, or half of a heart period, I think, yeah, it doesn't matter. You have to have literally half of a heart. If you have like half a red heart plus spirit hearts, that's not going to work. But just half of a heart, what umbilical cord will do will spawn a little Steven familiar for one room. That's it. A little Steven, like a mediocre familiar for a single room for getting down to half of a heart. It's like, I can't, like... The item makes sense thematically. Yes, I get it. The symbolism of the umbilical cord and Steven and all that stuff. That is fine. But at the same time, man, you gotta give me more than that. Can we at least have little Steven for as long as we have half of a heart? That's not that bad of a compromise, I don't think. Not a huge fan of this room, being honest right now. I can clear out these two, I'll be feeling a little better, though. It's just all the rocks on this room that make it somewhat hellish, but it'll be okay. I just really need to protect this one spirit heart that I have. Thankfully, I do have two bombs, so if I come across a tinted rock, we can make hay while the sun shines, as they say. I'm tempted to go for that pill, but at the same time, really don't want to hit myself on the spikes like a dummy and then have it not be balls of steel. Have it just be I'm excited again and I forgot the pill color or something. Amazing as it is, rooms like this are kind of like the worst for me right now, just because there's so many enemies, and even though they're all weak, it takes forever to clear them out. Thankfully, they shouldn't be able to hit me. Oh, come on. There we go. Alright. We got... Oh, shit. I will say that this is probably the worst run that I've had that has Sacred Heart. Sacred Heart is not an item to sneeze at by any measure. It is a very blessed, beloved item, extremely rare. Like, I'm amazed that it even appeared on this run. Shit. Is there a tinted rock on this room? There is not. So we are flying on pure red hearts right now, and I'm not super happy about it. Especially not against these assholes. There we go. Spirit heart? No, just bombs. Alright, I don't think I missed any tinted rocks either, so we're just going to keep going here. Oh, there's a tinted rock right there. Spirit hearts, please. Good enough, good enough. I'll make it work, I'll make it last. And I will survive. You're fine. I don't care about you. Getting lots of bombs now, so we don't have to worry about it so much, about preserving one for a deal with the angel chance. Okay, I guess head in and just pop box of friends. Well, first fire, then pop box of friends, do that whole shindig so we can get sort of a double tier rate, I guess. I guess kind of. There we go. Question mark card is a little tempting. I guess the incubi kind of fell back into sync here by the looks of things here, so maybe that strategy doesn't work as well as I was hoping it would. Alright, deal with the angel. Bless me, please. Oh, we're good. Okay. Good stuff, good stuff. Head on in here. Three spirit hearts is lovely. And I will go ahead and do this. I could use the question mark card, but honestly, I think you save that for the Mega Satan fight. Provided we get there. Our odds are looking much better than they were a second ago, that's for sure. That was just dumb, but it's okay. We have the cancer effect, so not going to be super concerned. There we go. Yeah, we'll save the question mark card plus a box of friends charge for Mega Satan. And we'll move on up here. This should be a testament, by the way, to the fact that, like I said, this is the worst run that I've had that also contains Sacred Heart. But we're still making it work fairly easily here, almost solely on the back of Sacred Heart. So it's just, that just shows how powerful of an item it really is, honestly. Even Curse of Darkness on this room is not so, or on this floor is not so bad. Thanks in part anyway to the stoplight, not the stoplight, the nightlight, the stoplight. New item coming to Afterbirth, Afterbirth Plus Plus. It's a passive that has a random chance of being either red, yellow, or green on any given room. Green will speed up all enemies on the room. Yellow will slow them down. And red will freeze them all for the entire room. That sounds like an extremely powerful item. Actually. I think it would probably be like yellow, they just go normal speed, and then red, they are slow or something instead. But at that point, it's literally just the broken watch, so who cares? But I mean, it wouldn't be the first time they've recycled an item that already exists for an expansion pack. Hi-yo! I don't mean to be disparaging. This is a great game. As you might guess by the fact that we're on episode 68 right now, so. 67, I think, actually, but it's okay. The numbers kind of start to blend together at some point. Probably, it might be worth checking out the cursed room. Nah. What am I hoping for? Like, the fucking pentagram? Do I really need more damage right now? I don't think so. I guess the pact could be okay. Actually would be great, but it is what it is. It's the odds of it being the pact, I'll just say, are not extraordinarily high. Okay, so we will get a box of friends charged just in time for the Isaac fight here, which will be nice. Should make things quite a bit easier for us. These greeds are being real assholes, I'll say that for sure. Alright, fistula, get dusted here. Just home in on them. I'll wait, man. I'll play the dodging game with fistula all day here, if we have to. Should be just about done. Thankfully, like, one of these coins is enough to take out even the silkworms, so. Alright. Head on in here. I was kind of wondering if that would double the Mega Satan key, and what that might entail. It's like, can I access Mega Satan with only one key piece if I have Box of Friends? Because I can just double the key piece? Wouldn't that be hilarious? No, I guess they thought about that one. Alright, doing pretty okay here, I would say. We're not going to go to the Mega Satan fight right off the bat. Because number one, we have to get a charge for Box of Friends. And number two, we can still fight Blue Baby on this run. Which I need to do as Lilith, so. I recently learned of, like, a potentially new safe spot to stand in this, Beams of Light attack. Like, right in the middle at the bottom here. I think I've seen other people doing that. I never really knew that to be a even potential possibility. Alright. I guess, yeah, move on down. Cue Curse of the Blind. Rune Bag has appeared in the basement. That's an extraordinary unlock. Curse of Darkness. Okay, that's not bad. We got the Game Kid. We got Magic Mush. We got Dead Sea Scrolls and the Pinking Shears, huh? I mean, three spacebar items is not great for me. I'll pick them all up just to get them out of the pool, I guess. And Magic Mush is really good. It's not a tiers upgrade? It says all stats, man. Aw, you piece of shit. Alright, well, that's fine. I will admit I was somewhat tempted by the offer of the Pinking Shears. And I may still consider it for the Mega Satan fight. We'll see. Just the value offer for the Pinking Shears, I think, is that it gives us a familiar that just does damage a lot faster than we can do. But Box of Friends gives us, like, so much more potential damage, I think. Because I don't think Pinking Shears is a great Mega Satan item. Really. It might be a great Blue Baby item, to be fair. I might have to go back for that. And that would work out well, actually, because then I'll have a full charge on Box of Friends for Mega Satan, and I can just swap out the items and be hunky-dory. For right now, I'm just going to keep on rocking a Box of Friends, though. I see no reason not to. There we go. No HP upgrades from either of the gluttony fights that we've had so far. You know what? This is probably worth it. There's gonna be so many enemies on this room that I need the extra firepower right now. Like I said, rooms with multiple enemies, regardless of how strong the enemies are, is my bane right now. Although, you know what? Despite the fact that this run has been a bit of an oddball, a bit of a weird sort of, like, good but not good run, I will give credit where credit is due. The game did give me damage. We are sitting at a 43 damage stat without Ipecac or anything crazy like that. I mean, granted, Magic Mush Sacred Heart is pretty crazy on its own, but Sacred Heart is pretty crazy on its own. That combined with Magic Mush. Now if we could only get, like, Cricket's Head or Judas or Shadow or something, we'd be in amazing shape. Of course, I wouldn't really want Judas or Shadow because I need to do this as Lilith. C'est la vie. Okay. So that room took about 5 minutes. Not really, but felt like it. And 5 minutes in Isaac time is quite a while. This room should take significantly less time. They're really rooms like that with like fistulas and teratomas and envies. They're gonna be what separate the boys from the men on this run. Who has the patience to withstand all that? All right, Spelunker Hat is fine. It's another light source against Curse of the Darkness. Yeah, I don't think it actually provides any light proper, but. We are on a bit of a sore spot in terms of our HP on this run. That's something I'm just kind of noticing right now. Even with the cancer effect, it's still going to be a bit hellish to try and get through the rest of this floor. Hopefully old bandage will come through in the clutch and placenta to make our lives a little bit easier here. But I think for the most part, we'll be fine. We do have a lot of red hearts on the ground as is, so. There's our super secret room. Don't get hit by this big champion either, because he'll ruin my day. Okay. I wonder how the damage calculates for the wafer damage against like a big champion. Because I don't know, does the wafer actually just like, or I guess the wafer or the cancer effect, does it actually half the damage that you take? Or does it just turn all damage into half of a heart? I don't fully know, because like those champions, the big ones, they do 2 full hearts of damage. So with the wafer active, would that in turn do 1 heart of damage or just half a heart? Not sure how that'd be calculated, but someone out there can test it or has tested it, I'm sure. I don't need to worry about it. It's a niche enough scenario anyway that you're probably not gonna run into it. I mean, for the longest time, I didn't even know those champions did do a full 2 hearts of damage. I didn't know anything in this game could do 2 hearts of damage, really, except for a sharp plug. But here we got an item. It is Leo. I don't think I'm super interested in that, honestly. There's not many rocks that I'm gonna be stomping around trying to find here. Leo could be made a little better if it let you open like stone chests and stuff without having to use a bomb. I think that would be a neat little sort of buff for Leo. I mean, Leo is honestly a good item most of the time if you get it early enough in the game that it probably doesn't need a buff, but it would be an interesting sort of novel usage for Leo, I think. Would you also apply that little benefit to Thunder Thighs and things like that? Probably, yeah, I think so. The nail, I don't know. The nail might be a bit of an oddball scenario. Although if you're willing to use your nail charge to open up a stone chest, I suppose you deserve to open up that stone chest. Don't run away from me. I don't know. These fucking hearts, man. My God. I don't know what causes that to happen, but I'm about sick of it. I'll tell you what. I should take out greed here first if I can. Just so I can get some potential benefit out of beating Wrath instead. I don't think I've ever touched on that, but in this room with like the 3 mini bosses, the payout that you get from the room depends on which one you kill last. Range up. We finally get a stat upgrade pill, and it's possibly the least valuable stat for me in this moment. I mean, I guess like a shot speed up would have been a lot worse, but I don't think that can come in the form of a pill either. At least not in not in Afterbirth Plus and Antibirth. I think that might be a thing, but all right. So I was gonna go back and swap out the pinking shears. I just remembered that, but that's okay. It's not gonna be the end of the world. Obviously, we still have enough rooms that we can go back and get a charge for the Mega Satan fight. I'm pretty sure. And either way, the Blue Baby fight was not gonna be a super pain with a box of friends or pinking shears. Not going to make a world difference. No void portal or anything, so don't have to worry about making that decision. Let's go ahead and get a charge going here. Gertie Jr. is not a fun enemy, but he does charge into my shots at least, so pretty sweet on that front. Is there just a battery charge on the ground maybe? No, there's not. I can go fight that big room, I guess. Although, do I really want to? I don't think I do, actually. I was on my way up there, and I'm like, eh, I don't really want to do that, because what if it's like four super enemies or something? I will be hating myself. Granted, I'm not a super fan of this room either, but I think it's better than four super enemies. I don't even know if that's a room that exists on the chest, to be fair. But better not to take my chances, I would say. Pick that up. It doesn't really matter if we're at a half-hour interval going into the Mega Satan fight, I don't think. Just because we have Placenta anyway, so it's probably going to screw up our interval no matter what we do. Aw, oh, I thought that had him, but he just blew himself with his bomb. Alright, that's fine too. Alright. So I guess I might as well just head into Mega Satan with full health if we can. There we go. Alright, we got full charge, we got question mark card. I think we're good to go. We cleared out Blue Baby. This is going to be a fine end to a weird run, I think. Let's do it. Let's pop both of these. And, triple Incubus. Let's go. Let's show them the what for. My god, those coins are so big. Like as big as Mega Satan's fucking hands. Jesus Christ. Alright. We did get hit, so that triggers our cancer effect, thankfully. I mean, the ideal outcome would have been that we never got hit, like, ever. But what are the odds of that, really? Okay. And old bandage, you've been working wonders on this run up to this point. But now is the time when you really need to pay out. Honestly, alright, Super Envy might be the worst thing we come up against in this Mega Satan fight, just because of the sheer amount of enemies that are going to be on the screen. But with triple Incubus, I think we'll be okay. Yeah, it's not so bad at all. And you know what, I was bemoaning the range upgrade a little bit earlier. I think the range upgrade is actually not that bad. Because my shots stay in the air for longer, so hell yeah. Got a little bit cornered there, that's okay. I'm not a fan of this. Alright. Getting a lot of money out of this, if nothing else. Maybe some of these are lucky pennies. Could come in nicely. Come in handy. Okay. These angels should not be that bad. They're the ones who gave me the power to do this in the first place, so... Joke's on you, motherfuckers. How's the Sacred Heart taste now? There we go. Alright, I think we got this Mega Satan fight roughly on lock. Don't count your chickens and all that, but I am getting ready to. I'm opening up the coop door. I'm looking in to see that all the chickens are up and at 'em, that none of the stalls are empty or anything. I'm getting ready to count. Looking at those eggs, man. Looking at those eggs, just waiting for them to hatch. Thank you, old bandage. There we go, alright. Void portal? Void portal. Alright, here we go, I guess. Let's go for the quadruple knockout. Isaac, Blue Baby, Mega Satan, and Delirium. Gaming Conception has appeared in the basement, and Big Baby has appeared in the basement. What'd you call me? Alright, no curse on the void. I'm actually quite thankful for that. I am going to take a moment here to pause my recording. Because the last thing I need right now is for this to corrupt on me after this run of all things, so I'll be right back. Alright, we're back in action here. Let's give this a whirl. I don't know what my odds are, really, of getting to and defeating Delirium. I don't feel like they're that great given the current state of my HP, but given the shot here, and it's not gonna have a super big win streak to protect it right now or anything, I figure might as well. Alright, a second seam sale, so everything in the shop is free from now on. Hell yeah. If only there were a shop on the void, I'd be singing the praises of that. I do also have the super potentially boring play right now, if I want to, of just sitting around and waiting for Placenta to regenerate all of my HP. But I mean, hopefully it'll just regenerate on its own over the course of this floor. And hopefully I can maybe just find some red hearts or spirit hearts as well. Make that work out nicely. We got a battery charge there that could be pretty good, potentially. Gotta make sure you use those Box of Friends charges adequately, and never enter a boss room without a Box of Friends charge ready to go. Because if it is Delirium, you want that Box of Friends charge, no doubt. Oh god. Hey, back off! Drop a heart for me, you assholes. There's a red champion who is supposed to drop a heart, man. An eternal heart, huh? I mean, I'll save that on the ground for right now, because a second eternal heart could potentially drop and give me just a full HP upgrade, which would be pretty sweet. Don't know that's all that likely, but... Alright, we got explosive diarrhea. Really looking for, like, a full health pill at this point now. Go. Man, this is gonna be like the fucking... It's like one of the... This is like the third video in a sequence of like four videos that's gonna be over an hour long. It's kind of... I don't know what that says about me as a player. Or my abilities are devolving or something. But... Alright, I don't want to go into that boss fight just yet because it could be Delirium just judging by the room layout. I think it could be anyway. Oh shit, I hear sirens outside. They're coming for me. They're like, this run's taking too long. You're about to be put in the slammer if you don't finish it up soon, buddy. I'll try and finish. I'm not going to go too crazy trying to min-max the void floor here. But I would like to go into the Delirium fight with a little more than two red hearts. Call me crazy. I think that could be a wise idea. Man, I'm really banking on these champions dropping more hearts than this, but I just don't want to, I guess. I don't think this can be Delirium. Alright, it's not. That's good. Brownie, so it's not great, because he spawns a million enemies, but... But we'll survive, if only by the skin of our teeth. Alright, the rosary is huge. Do you take it right now, though? I think you kind of have to, because I'm resting on one red heart. That's not enough, because one red heart will not protect me from a single hit. The rosary, unfortunately, I would wish I could have saved that for when I knew I was about to go into the Delirium fight. No reason to go to that room, I don't think. But you gotta do what you gotta do to survive to the Delirium fight, I think. Even this late in the fucking run, this room is still bullshit. Are you seeing this? These Stonies are the greatest goalies of all time. Forget Kippersoff, man. Get these Stonies on lock. That could easily be Delirium, so I'm not going to check that out just yet. Maybe I should. Is my HP going to get much better than this? I don't know. I mean, I kind of just want to, like, fight bosses on the off chance that I can get some good items out of it, potentially, is my thinking. I will not forget my one rule, though, for fighting a boss, is that I should go in with a full charge and a Box of Friends. That much is not even debatable. So go ahead and clear out this room to get that charge, I guess. Sweet. Alright, and then check out this room. What do we got? It's Mom's Heart, so that's not the worst thing in the world. These laser eyes are kind of assholes, but we'll make it work. I could have boxed the friends on this room, it might still be a good idea, but I'd like to save it, if possible. Huge if true. I'll never get used to this Mom's Heart fight on any room but on like a womb type style room. Having it on like a death style room like this is just so weird to me. Paid out with the Bible, huh? I mean, that's a bookworm transformation, I think. Yeah. So what that does for us, I'm not entirely confident, but it seems to double my shots occasionally, which could be pretty nice. I'm going here. That cannot be Delirium, I don't think. Mama Gertie, alright, that's fine. No flight, so this is a little nastier than it otherwise would be. But she'll go down pretty fast anyway. There we go. What do you got for me? Got BOGO bombs. Oh my god, I could not think of a less enthusiastic item for me right now. Let's go check out this boss over here. I've got a bad feeling that this one in particular is Delirium, but I'm just gonna check it. It's Teratoma, alright. Still not my ideal boss fight. It's a damn sight better than Delirium, I'll tell you that much. Stay away from me. I really need tiers upgrades though, man. Have I gotten a single tiers upgrade on this entire fucking game? Yes, I did. I got anti-grav tiers, which is a tiers upgrade with a weird little hitch. So take that with a grain of salt, I guess. Balls of steel. Bombs are key. So two balls of steel kills. Oh God. Two bombs of steel kills. I think you save the balls of steel pills for right now. And then hope that you can use them more strategically to get some more HP in the Delirium fight. I don't know if that's necessarily the wisest move, or if it's even going to make a difference if I use them now or later. But god damn it, I'm going to try my best to... I don't want to min-max everything, but if I'm given the opportunity to min-max without having to go out of my way too much, I'm going to take it. This is actually hell. I'm going to go ahead and pop that, because there's triple mega fatties in here. But even their tankiness cannot stand up to the fearsome might of double incubus with Bookworm. Get out of here. Alright. I feel like the commentary's a little sparse on this run. I just don't feel like I have much to say anymore. The run is what it is, you know? It's not the most interesting thing I've ever seen, that's for sure. Blind Rage is probably better. I don't know, might not be. There's a case to be made for both trinkets in that circumstance, I think, but Blind Rage right now, I'm just feeling it more. Maybe it's because I'm in a Blind Rage myself. No, I'm not. I'm not quite at that level of assault here. This is a good run. This is also a tasty burger, for those who were wondering. Ooh, double boss fights. Could one be Delirium? Let's find out, I suppose. Keep the balls of steel pill on me. Let's check this out. Satan. Alright, we're getting all the special bosses out of the way, I guess. Satan, fucking mom's heart. Isaac, blue baby, mega Satan. I mean, I fought your dad a second ago, Satan, so I don't know how you're gonna compare here, but... There's a discussion. Who is the harder boss, Satan or Mega Satan? It's absolutely Mega Satan. There's not, like, you might think, like, just thinking about it, it's like, oh, maybe there's a case to be made for Satan. Like, in the moment, he seems pretty hard, but that's just it. It's in the moment. In the moment, Mega Satan is a fucking hellscape a lot of the time. Not as bad as Delirium or Hush or anything like that, but still pretty gnarly. Alright, Distant Admiration is... a thing. It's a means of dealing damage. That's that. This just screams Delirium to me. In fact, it screams Delirium so much that I might be ready to pop the balls of steel pills. And I will head back to that, do that other boss fight. I just kind of neglected it there, but... What do we got? We got Wheel of Fortune. I don't think this does anything for me if I blow it up here. That's only on the chest, then that would apply. Yeah, I guess Pushpin might be better. Maybe. I don't know, man. The cage, the double cage, can get fucked. Please. Okay. Balls of steel, pop that. The Polaroid did trigger there, but... Alright. And we got Linger Bean, which is, That's the thing about this run. A lot of the things just, they are what they are, you know? That's such a meaningless phrase, and I hate having to use it so often, but Linger Bean is not bad, I guess. It's not great, though. I'd say that for sure. Alright, running back for this Balls of Steel pill really quick, and then I'm going to check out that room at the end of that corridor, because that seems so likely to be Delirium to me. Just the placement of it is too perfect, you know? Sometimes you just get that feeling... Like, tonight's gonna be a good night. Like, tonight's gonna be, you know, a good night. Like, it's gonna be a good night. Alright, well, let's never do that again. Balls of steel. Check these. You never know. Ooh, you do never know. Temperance, okay. Yeah, you never know when you're going to get a temperance card. There's delirium. Okay. Pop that. Oh, that's... come on. That's just mean. That's meaner. Okay, focus. Don't be a dumbass about this now. You've made it to the delirium fight with somewhat of a fighting chance. Don't blow that chance by just walking into fucking Gertie Jr. We are doing so much damage right now, though, that it is a... It's almost like illegal how much damage we're doing. It's not the highest damage stat I've ever had, mind you. Fucking... He keeps doing that. Can that be illegal, please? Him just teleporting, like, on top of me? Telefragging me, I think is what the kids call it. These spiders are... Alright. I can be extremely thankful for the cancer item right now. And ideally, I would like to be thankful for old bandage. See? He's doing it every single fucking time. He knows that I have a chance to win here, and he's not gonna let it go easily. I'll tell you that much. He's not gonna go quietly into the night. Not this delirium. Oh, geez. See? I just feel like it's a little unfair. Like, delirium can be unfair sometimes. I think this is pushing it to a new limit, though. I don't know, maybe I'm just not supposed to move as much? Is that the plan here? Alright, oh, okay. That one, I think, was avoidable, so that's kind of on me. I don't know where these bomb flies are coming from, but I'm not happy with it. Every shot that we land on Delirium does, like, a pretty significant amount of his HP, so we're getting close here. It's gonna come down to the wire, this fight, I think. Right, he doesn't teleport on top of me or near me too much anymore. I should be okay. See, I don't think he ever actually teleports on top of me. I don't think the game is quite that unfair or that ruthless. I think he often teleports very, very close to me, though. And then my instinct is to, like, I just look at him because he's teleport close to me. And it's the whole driving principle is that you look where you want to go. So if I'm looking at Delirium, I'm probably going to walk into Delirium, or I'm more likely to anyway. Did I get those laser eyes? Tell me I did. Alright, I did. Alright, good. I didn't know if I got both of them. Oh, there's some more. Oh, Jesus. I was worried that I was going to cross, like, the entire room. Okay. He's not happy over there. He's having a hissy fit in the corner. Temperance is a possibility that I had not considered up to this moment. Do it. No, blow that shit up. Oh, god damn it. Well, I got that anyway. I probably got hit just trying to get the temperance thing to pop. But come on, he's so close. He's right fucking there. Oh my god. Oh, shit. Why am I flashing back to that room with blind rage? I don't know. That was way too much, man. Well, this has been an experience that I am glad that I had, but I kind of hope to never repeat. So, what the fuck? That don't scare me like that, man. Whoa. Alright. Euthanasia has appeared in the basement. Great item. Good stuff for Lilith, though. That was an extremely productive run. Now all we have to do with Lilith is the Dark Room and Greed and Greedier, so I am fine with that. Regardless, thank you everyone so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the run. It was an enjoyable one in a sense, I would say. If you did, please leave a like and or comment down below. It really helps out the video and the channel. And subscribe if you want to see more of these videos. I post a single Isaac video every day at noon Mountain Time. And I'd love to see you for the next one. Yeah, for sure, don't you know? That's going to be for today's, though. So thank you, everyone, for watching. This is ArgonMatrix, signing out. Thank you and good night.